कैन आई प्रोसीड?
यस सर।
ओके ओके, सो आई थिंक इन लास्ट सेशन आई डिस्कस द एनालिसिस पार्ट ऑफ योर ओएसटी, एंड इन एनालिसिस पार्ट ऑफ योर ओएसटी आई ड्रॉ थ्री व्हीकल, व्हिच इज वन ऑफ योर व्हीकल इज ए व्हीकल, नेक्स्ट इज योर व्हीकल बी, एंड थर्ड वन इज योर व्हीकल सी. सो बेसिकली इफ यू सी important parts, so I draw again. Just see here. So this is your divided carriage wheel. Basically, from this direction, your vehicle A is moving. This is the position of vehicle A. Here also your vehicle B is moving, or your slow speed vehicle is moving. Here also your slow speed vehicle is moving. After overtaking process, your vehicle A will comes to the this place. Also from opposite direction, another vehicle is moving, which is your vehicle C. So basically this is the condition of your vehicle C. Here this is your vehicle which is moving with your speed C. So this is the another vehicle. So let's see here, this is your vehicle A, this is your vehicle A, also this is your vehicle A. Next, this is your vehicle A, this is your vehicle B, 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 this is your vehicle A. This is your vehicle C, or the vehicle which will be moving from opposite direction. Is it visual to everyone? Aapko dikhai de raha hai?
Yes.
Okay. 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 So I extend this pavement. So basically, here I also extend this pavement. Okay, so this is the condition of our pavement, and basically this vehicle, I know what that this vehicle A is moving with its design speed, and suppose this A vehicle will move with a speed of 70 km per hour, I know. But when this vehicle want to overtake the vehicle which will be moving with slow speed, for certain period of time he reduce its speed from design speed to the speed of VB, or our IRC will do many research on OST, and he suggests that the vehicle which is our overtaking vehicle for certain period of time will moves with the speed of our overtaken vehicle. So basically this is, just wait. So this is the overtaking vehicle. So for certain period of time, this vehicle will move with the speed of our overtaken vehicle. So basically this speed is VB. Also for certain period of time or the speed which will be shown by vehicle B is its own speed. So basically this is the speed of our vehicle B. So this vehicle will move with VB. After overtaking operation, our vehicle A will move with its design speed. So this is the condition here. After overtaking process, this vehicle will move with their own design speed. So this is the condition of VD. So this is the condition after overtaking. Next, what is the speed of opposite moving vehicle? So basically here the vehicle which moves with opposite direction, the speed of this vehicle is design speed. Also this vehicle will move with its speed, and that speed is its design speed. So basically this is the VD. So here overtaking movement will be split into three operation. First operation is our D1, second operation is our D2, and third operation is our D3. So you just remember this point here. Our this OST movements, that means overtaking movements, will be split into three operations. First operation is D1. First operation is known as D1. So basically this is our D1 operation. Next is our D2 operation. So this is our D2 operation. So this is our D2 operation. And third is our D3 operation. So basically this is our D3 operation. And for this is our overshape condition, that means this is OST is overshape. So we go for only safe condition. If we go for only safe condition, then we make our opposite moving vehicle on similar section of A. So basically this is the condition of opposite moving vehicle. This vehicle will move with the speed of VD or design speed. So here three speeds or three distance comes in picture. This distance is known as D1. This distance is known as D1. This distance is known as D2. This distance is known as D2. And this distance is known as D3. And this distance is known as D3. This distance is known as D3. So basically this is our complete OST. This is our complete overtaking side distance. OSD. This is our complete OST. So OST is equal to D1 plus D2 plus D3. So I think before 5 minutes before I say that overtaking movement will be split into three operation. First operation is your D1, second operation is your D2, and third operation is your D3. If you carefully see here, this is the condition or this is the maneuvering of our overtaking vehicle. So from here our vehicle start overtaking, from here our vehicle start overtaking. कोई मत ये सोच लेना कि सर ये तो छोटा व्हीकल है, इसी जगह से पास हो जाएगा। तुमको पता है कि अगर हमारा 2 लेन रोड है, 7 मीटर का है, एक व्हीकल का 2.44 मीटर हमारा स्टैंडर्ड उसका जो होता है बिर्थ होता है, तो ऐसा नहीं है कि इस जगह से पास हो जाएगा। ये छोटा बना दिया है बॉक्स, इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि व्हीकल जो है इधर से निकल जाएगा। ओवरटेक करने के लिए हमको दूसरे लेन में आना पड़ता है, ये डे टू डे ऑब्जर्वेशन है। जब तुमको एक ट्रक जो स्लो मूविंग आगे तुम्हारे आगे स्लो मूविंग व्हीकल है जो धीरे धीरे मूव कर रहा है, उसको ओवरटेक करने के लिए तुमको दूसरे लेन में आना पड़ता है। और ये आई थिंक बहुत प्रैक्टिकल चीज़ है जो तुम लोग ऑब्जर्व कर चुके होगे। किए हो ऐसा ओवरटेक कभी किए हो कि नहीं किए हो? किए हो?
Yes.
ठीक है। तो कभी ऐसा हो जाता है कि सामने वाला जो व्हीकल आ जाता है वो तुम्हारे आगे आके रोक देता है, फिर घर जाके बताते हो आज तो बच गए, नहीं तो आज लपेट देता, ऐसा कभी होता है क्या? बेचारा वो बचा देता है, होता है क्या ऐसा कभी? या फिर कभी कभी ऐसा भी होता है कि हम अपने व्हीकल को जब बाद में पता चलता है तो सोचते हैं कि भाई ओवरटेक कर लेना चाहिए था, वो तो धीरे धीरे आ रहा था, हम उसके स्पीड का अंदाज़ा ही नहीं लगा पाए। तो ये पूरा का पूरा तुम्हारा वेस्ट है। सो बेसिकली दिस इज द मैनूवरिंग ऑफ ओवरटेकिंग व्हीकल। दैट मीन्स हियर आवर व्हीकल स्टार्ट एक्सीलरेटिंग एंड हियर दे इंक्रीज योर देयर रेट ऑफ एक्सीलरेशन, हियर दे इंक्रीज देयर रेट ऑफ एक्सीलरेशन, दे कम इन दिस लेन एंड आफ्टर ओवरटेकिंग द स्लो मूविंग व्हीकल दे कम्स इन देयर ओरिजिनल लेन। सो बेसिकली दीज आर द बेसिक पॉइंट व्हिच इन्वॉल्व इन आवर एनालिसिस ऑफ ओएसटी। If you carefully see, also D2 is bifurcated in three parts. Here also D2 is bifurcated in three parts. So here, during your overtaking operations, that means when you overtake the slow moving vehicle, in that particular time, your slow moving vehicle will also move, because if you overtake any vehicle, that means a truck, a bus, a four wheeler, that in that particular time, that means your during overtaking time, your slow moving vehicle will also moving. So here, this is the condition of your slow moving vehicle. This is the condition of your fast moving vehicle. Here you already know this vehicle A will moves with their own design speed. But after certain times, they wants to overtake this vehicle. So our analysis part will start with after certain times, when they see this object or when they want to overtake this object. So here we consider the speed of our vehicle A is VB, then they continuously move with the same speed VB. This is the speed of our slow moving vehicle VB, no problem. Here this vehicle oscillates once again and they overtake this slow moving vehicle and then comes in their own lane. Here opposite moving vehicle will moves with their design speed VD, or it is also known as VC, that means speed of opposite vehicle VC, or it is also known as capital V. So for analysis of OST, we split our OST into three operation. First is our D1, second is our D2, and third is our D3. In D1 part, D1 is your distance, because overtaking side distance. In overtaking side distance, you have to calculate distance. So here we calculate three distance. First is D1, second is D2, and third is D3. So basically D1 is the, if you see here, this D1 distance, if you carefully see here, this D1 distance. Basically D1 is the distance travel by your overtaking vehicle. This is your overtaking vehicle. D1 is the distance travel by your overtaking vehicle A during the reaction time T of the driver before starting to overtake vehicle B at a speed of VB. So basically this is your distance which will be taken traveled by your overtaking vehicle A during the reaction time T of the driver before starting to overtake. This is the condition before starting to overtake. After this condition, after D1, this vehicle will start overtaking. So D1 is the distance which will be traveled by overtaking vehicle A during the reaction time T of the driver before starting to overtake vehicle B at a speed of VB. So this is the speed of our VB. So basically D1 is the distance which will be traveled by our overtaking vehicle D during the reaction time D of the driver before starting to overtake vehicle B, and the speed of our overtaking vehicle is VB. So this D1 is clear. So for calculation of D1, we just multiply our reaction time with VB. So if you see VB into T, VB is in your meter per second and this T is your reaction time. So basically this gives us D1. So D1 is equal to VB into TR. If you change this speed in kilometer per hour, you have to multiply with 0.278. I already discussed this thing in your SST. So basically this is 0.278. This is your small VB. I mark it as a small VB. This is in meter per second. This is your capital VB, 0.278 VB. And here, just keep this point in your mind, a note point. Is the note point, note that reaction time in the case of OSD is taken to be 2 seconds, not 2.5 seconds. You always remember these things. What I before starting the class in first session, I discussed the height of object above the surface or above the pavement is also taken as 1.2 meter. But in SST, I take 0.15 meter. Also in SST, we take the total reaction time of driver as 2.5 seconds. But in the calculation of OST part, we take the reaction time of driver as 2 seconds. So basically here, TR is equal to 2 seconds. If they not given in question, they, you take your reaction time as 2 seconds. You do not take TR as 2.5 seconds. It is mandatory for the case of OST, which will be given by our code or which will be given by our IRC. So keep this point in your mind. If you multiply with 2.5, then your answer comes out to be wrong. And in your GATE examination, they give to find OST and they multiply your VB with 2.5 seconds or option is given as option A, option B, or option C, or option D. So in many options, you find that your reaction time is 2.5 seconds taken for the case of OST, which is absolutely wrong, because for the calculation of OST, our reaction time of the driver is taken as 2 seconds by IRC. So is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is our D1 part. D1 part is our, basically D1 is the distance traveled by overtaking vehicle A during the reaction time T of the driver before starting to overtake vehicle B at speed of VB. Basically, this is the speed of our overtaking vehicle. Also, here our speed of overtaken vehicle is VB. So what is D2? So if you carefully see here, D2 is further split into three parts. So I try to split this D2 into three parts. So just wait. So nothing is left if you understand these things. So also in D2, three operations is involved. So for calculation of OST, you have to be consider your D1, which is over. You just multiply this D1 with VB into TR. I discussed about D2. So in D2, three operations is also involved. In D2, three operations is involved. One is B. One is known as B. So basically B is the distance which will be traveled by our overtaken vehicle. So for, during overtaking time, दैट मीन्स जब हम ओवरटेक कर रहे हैं उस टाइम ऐसा नहीं है कि हमारा जो स्लो मूविंग व्हीकल है वो बेचारा रुक जाएगा और बोलेगा कि फास्ट मूविंग व्हीकल तुम हमको ओवरटेक कर लो फिर हम चलना स्टार्ट करेंगे, वो भी कंटिन्यूसली चलते रहेगा। तो जो डिस्टेंस हमारा स्लो मूविंग व्हीकल मूव किया उस डिस्टेंस को हम बी बोले। सो बेसिकली दिस इज बी। उसके बाद ये जो डिस्टेंस होता है दोनों साइड में इसको हम लोग बोलते हैं एस। सो बेसिकली दिस इज स्पेस हेडवे। ऐसा नहीं है कि हम अपना जो भी ओवरटेकिंग व्हीकल है और जो भी ओवरटेकन व्हीकल है वो दोनों उसका रेयर जो है उसके फ्रंट में सटा हुआ रहता है। ऐसा नहीं कि आगे जो व्हीकल जा रहा है पीछे से जो व्हीकल है उसको इसमें पूरा का पूरा सट जा रहा है, नहीं, वो कुछ ना कुछ क्लियर स्पेसिंग और क्लियर डिस्टेंस रखता है उसके बाद जाके वो ओवरटेक करता है। वैसा थोड़ी है कि तुम ट्रक के पीछे एकदम गाड़ी सटा ली और वहाँ से ओवरटेक कर जाओगे। अब बीच में हो ओवरटेक जैसे ही करना चाहोगे कि इसके इस वाले आउटर एज पे तुम इसे टकरा जाओगे ट्रक से ही, तो इसके लिए तुम एक क्लियर डिस्टेंस मेंटेन करते हो जो डिस्टेंस हम लोग का स्पेस हेडवे कहलाता है। सो बेसिकली दिस डी टू इज ऑल्सो बाइफर्केटेड इंटू थ्री पार्ट। फर्स्ट इज योर एस, नेक्स्ट इज योर बी एंड लास्ट इज ऑल्सो एस। सो बेसिकली डी टू इज ऑल्सो रिटेन एज, हियर डी टू इज ऑल्सो रिटेन एज बी टू इज इक्वल टू बी प्लस टू एस और टू एस प्लस बी। आई राइट डी इज इक्वल टू बी प्लस टू एस। सो बी इज द डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल बाय स्लो मूविंग व्हीकल और ओवरटेकन व्हीकल एंड एस इज बेसिकली आवर स्पेस हेड बे। सो स्पेस हेड बे इज द मिनिमम स्पेसिंग बिटवीन टू व्हीकल। आई ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दिस इज द फैक्टर विच गवर्न्स ओ एस टी बिकॉज ड्यूरिंग ओ एस टी कंसिडरेशन आई डिस्कस डिफरेंट फैक्टर विच affect our OST and the factor which govern our OST is distance between two vehicle. So basically this is the distance and here this distance is written as S. So S is equal to minimum spacing or minimum distance between two vehicle which also depends upon the vehicle speed, or this S is also known as space headway. I discuss this term space headway in your traffic engineering. So do not worry, D2 is equal to B plus 2S. Now comes to point D3. So what is D2? D2 is the distance traveled by vehicle A during the overtaking operation of time T. So basically here two times comes in picture. One is small t, this is our reaction time, and next time is T. This is our overtaking time. So basically this is from here to here. The time taken by vehicle from here to here, this is our condition of overtaking operation. This is the condition of overtaking operation. So basically, during overtaking operation, how much time vehicle take to overtake? So this time is known as overtaking time, and this time is denoted as capital T. So I discuss three distances. First is your D1. Second is your D2 and last one is your D3. So D1 is the distance traveled by overtaking vehicle A during the reaction time T of driver before starting to overtake vehicle B. Next is your D2. So basically D2 is the distance traveled by vehicle A during the overtaking operation of time capital T. So here basically capital T is our overtaking time. Next is D3. So D3, here is your D3. So if you see carefully, D3 is the distance traveled by oncoming vehicle C during the actual overtaking operation of your vehicle A for time capital T. So basically D3 is the distance traveled by your opposite moving vehicle during your overtaking operational time. So basically during overtaking process, our opposite moving vehicle will move certain distance. This distance is known as D3, and this D3 is calculated with the help of our operational time, which is capital T. So for calculating D3, we just multiply our speed, that means BD with capital T or BC, because I already say this design speed of vehicle C is also written as BC into capital T. Here this BC is also written as capital B into T. So if you want to convert it in kilometer per hour, then you just multiply. So this is your V. If this is given in your meter per second, then you just, this is in your meter per second, then you just multiply it with your 0.278. So basically this is 0.278 into capital V into T. So is it clear to everyone? We calculate our D1 is equal to 0.278 VP into TR. So this is our D1. D2 is equal to B plus 2S. So D2 is equal to B plus 2S, and D3 is equal to 0.278 into V into T. So this capital T is our operating, or the time which will be taken during the overtaking operation. So this time is known as overtaking time. So capital T is our overtaking time. So is it clear to everyone? Okay, so I draw three figures, so you all just give me which is your, in which case your OSD is safe, or in which case your OSD is over safe, or in which case collision is possible. So in your GATE examination, one question is asked, I think in 2016, they asked. Okay, bolo.
ओके
ठीक है, खुद सोच लो, हम कुछ नहीं बता रहे हैं, खुद सोच के बता दो, टू लेन है
सर तो पीछे से तो कॉलिजन हो सकता है ना सर।
अच्छा देखो, यहाँ पे दो लेन बना हुआ है, यहाँ पे तुम्हारा 7 मीटर का यहाँ पे है तुम्हारा, ये 7 मीटर का है, और वन वे ट्रैफिक तुम बता रहे हो कि सर हमारा इधर से कोई व्हीकल नहीं आ रहा है, वन वे ही है, मतलब इधर से ही कोई व्हीकल तुम्हारा जा रहा है, इधर से ही तुम्हारा व्हीकल जा रहा है, तो इधर से व्हीकल के कॉलिजन का क्या चांस है, इधर से जब तुम्हारा टू वे है, दो वे है और वन, और टू लेन ट्रैफिक है, ये तुम्हारा एक लेन, ये तुम्हारा डिवाइडेड कैरिज वे है, और ये इधर से तुम्हारा टू लेन है और वन वे ही है, वन वे मतलब इधर से तुम्हारा व्हीकल आ ही नहीं रहा, तो इस केस में तुम्हारा डी थ्री नहीं आएगा तो तुम्हारा ओएसटी जो है कम आएगा, समझ में आ गया? ठीक है, ठीक से बोलो, आवाज नहीं आ रहा तुम्हारा। हाँ बोलो
सर, पीछे से बैक कॉलिजन तो कॉलिजन तो होगा ना सर, तो वो तो उसके लिए भी तो हम लोग कुछ डिजाइन कर सकते हैं।
तो बैक कॉलिजन होगा जब तुम क्लियर स्पेस हेड वे मेंटेन नहीं करोगे, तभी तो बैक कॉलिजन हो जाएगा। अगर तुमको पता है कि इतना डिस्टेंस हमको लेके चलना है, तो फिर हमारा बैक कॉलिजन क्यों होगा? स्पेस हेड वे बताए ना कि एस होता है एक, हम लोग मिनिमम डिस्टेंस को हम लोग लेके चलते हैं, ये जो मिनिमम स्पेस हेडवे होता है इसको हम लोग स्पेस हेडवे बोलते हैं, तो ये मिनिमम स्पेस हेडवे हमको मेंटेन करना पड़ता है, जो कि बताएं कि ट्रैफिक इंजीनियरिंग में जब आएंगे तो स्पेस हेडवे हमको डिटेल में पढ़ना है। बाद बाकी अगर तुम बात कर रहे हो कि सर अगर हमारा टू लेन रोड है तो उस केस में, और वन वे ही ट्रैफिक है तो उस केस में क्या होगा, तो उस केस में हमारा ओ एस टी कम हो जाएगा। और कोलिजन का क्या बात है, कोलिजन तो तुम जो तुम्हारे आगे मोटरसाइकिल ये चल रहा था, एक मान के चलो ऑटो रिक्शा चल रहा था, तुम्हारा मन किया इसको ठोक सकते हैं, कोलिजन करा दो इसको, लेकिन अगर इसके पीछे 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 अगर कुछ डिस्टेंस मेंटेन करके चल रहे हैं तो क्यों होगा कोलिजन? अब मन है तो मेरा ट्रक में भी धक्का मार सकते हैं आगे जो जा रहा है, मन पे थोड़ी कंट्रोल। ठीक है, और कोई डाउट है तो पूछो। अच्छा है, पूछो, और किसी को कोई डाउट है तो। लेकिन अभी हम OST बता रहे हैं, तो OST में बताए तुमको कि अगर हमारा 2-लेन रोड है, 1-वे ट्रैफिक है, मतलब एक ही तरफ से गाड़ी जा रहा है, तो उस केस में हमारा OST कम आएगा, क्योंकि हमारा D3 पिक्चर में नहीं आएगा। तो D3 जब पिक्चर में नहीं आएगा तो D3 को ऐड ही नहीं करेंगे, तो D1+D2 जाएगा, तो OST हमारा कम आ जाएगा। अब बोले कि सर यहाँ पे हमारा गाड़ी जा रहा है तो ये कोलिजन पीछे से नहीं हो सकता है क्या? कहीं भी कोलिजन हो सकता है, सामने से भी कोलिजन हो सकता है। जरूर देखे हो गया, तुम्हारे आगे एक वो ऑटो रिक्शा जा रहा है, मोटरसाइकिल उस पर टच कर ही देता है, आगे 4-व्हीलर जा रहा है, मोटरसाइकिल वाला उसको टच कर ही देता है। क्यों? क्योंकि वो एक क्लियर स्पेस हेड पे जो हमको मेंटेन करना पड़ता है, जो हमारा IRC बताया है, जो ट्रैफिक इंजीनियरिंग में ये पूरा हमको डिटेल में ही पढ़ना है, तो वहाँ पे हम लोग देखेंगे कि हम लोग को कितना स्पेस हेड पे रखना पड़ता है। नहीं रखेंगे तो सामने वाले को ठोक देंगे, ठोक देने के बाद फिर वो उतरेगा, फिर हमसे मांगेगा कि भाई तुम मेरे गाड़ी को ठोक दिया, पैसा ला। और ये तो डे टू डे होता ही है, कितना बार हम लोग भी देखे हैं, तुम लोग भी देखे होगे, है कि नहीं? ओके, चले आगे।
यस सर।
ओके, गुड। सो नेक्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ डिस्कशन इज योर OST इज सेफ, OST इज ओवर सेफ और कंजेस्टेड, बताओ यहीं पे तुम लोगों को समझ में आ जाएगा। द कंडीशन ऑफ here in this direction our opposite vehicle is coming, so basically here our vehicle comes this position, here our vehicle comes to this position, here our vehicle comes to this position, from opposite direction the vehicle comes and the opposite moving vehicle is also come to this point. This is opposite moving vector. Next, this is our opposite moving vector. This is our opposite moving vector, and this is also our opposite moving vector. This is vector C. This is vector C. This is vector C. And this is vector A. This is vector A. This is vector A. And also this is vehicle A. So, can anyone say where your OST is safe, where your OST is over safe, and where your congested overtaking or collision is possible? So can anyone say? This is your condition one. this is your condition 2, this is your condition 3. So in first condition, your vehicle A will maneuver and will overtake your slow moving vehicle and comes at this particular section, and also at this section your opposite moving vehicle will come. Next, in next case or in second case, your vehicle will, your overtaking vehicle will overtake or maneuver the slow moving vehicle, comes at this particular section, but this opposite moving vehicle will far from your overtaking vehicle. Here this is the another case where your vehicle will wants to overtake the slow moving vehicle, but at same time your opposite moving vehicle will come on the same lane or at same situation where your overtaking vehicle and your opposite moving vehicle come face to face. So which is the condition of OST, where what is the condition of OST which we called as safe, which we called as oversafe, or which we called as congested overtaking, or where collision is possible? So can anyone say?
तो थर्ड वाला में कोलिजन हो जाएगा और सेकंड वाला में ओवरसेफ.
ओके,
सेकंड वाला ओवरसेफ, फर्स्ट वाला सेफ
और थर्ड वाला. ओके, सो गुड गुड. सो दिस इज योर, सो इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीवन? दिस इज योर सेफ. हियर ओएसटी इज सेफ, राइट? हियर ओएसटी इज सेफ, ओएसटी इज सेफ, हियर आवर ओएसटी इज सेफ. Here our OST is safe. Here our OST is extra safe. That means our safe. OST is our safe. Is our safe. And last one is, what is the condition of last one?
Congested, sir.
Okay, so this is our congested OST, or collision is possible. So I think these all are our practical aspects, and I observe these things in our day-to-day life. So basically, in today's session or in today's class, I'm discussing about your OST. Next, I define OST and what are the importance of OST. I discuss. Next is your factors which affect our OST. Next, I do the analysis of OST, and we bifurcate our OST in three parts. First is D1, second is your D2, and third is your D3. Then I discuss how we calculate D1, how we calculate D2, how we calculate D3.